Depuis le début des années 60, le pianiste Herbie Hancock a été au cœur de bien des révolutions qui ont agité le petit monde du jazz. Pourtant, il n'a pas toujours connu la gloire, comme il le rappelle lors de son discours de réception du prix Miles Davis en 1997, évoquant cette leçon d'humilité que lui avait donnée un public berlinois au terme d'une prestation du groupe Headhunters. Du même coup, Herbie Hancock en profite pour nous dire tout ce qu'il retient de ses années auprès de Miles Davis.
Well, I will say one thing. I thought the Oscar was the heaviest award in the world. You got them beat by a mile. You know, I was just thinking that back in 1974, I played a concert in Berlin with a band that we called it the Headhunters Band. And we played our hearts out, and frankly, the music was really burning. It was burning. And we finished, and the audience stood up, and they booed. And they threw eggs, and they threw tomatoes, and water. And they hissed, and they whistled real loud, you know. You know, they were really angry, you know. How dare Herbie Hancock play this music, you know. One of the greatest things that Miles stood for, which of course applied to his music, but also applied to his life, is that he stood for courage, the courage of his convictions. And a lot of people don't realize how great Miles was as a human being and what he had to offer his young sidemen, you know, from the 60s. That Miles provided a platform for us to be able to really take risks, challenge ourselves, you know, not take the easy road out, you know, find new things to develop, new things to play. Well, at that time, I was too young to realize about applying it to my life. But about the time of when I recorded the Headhunters album, I began to really understand what those lessons that I learned from Miles were about. And that experience in Berlin was a very important experience for my life because I got a chance to feel a little bit of what it feels like when everybody is against you and you only have the strength of your own convictions about what you believe in to make you hold your head high. And the next year, 1975, we played Berlin again. The same band, the same music, and they were dancing in the aisles. You know, so it makes a really, really big difference. And when you had the good fortune to have someone encourage you to try to bring out the best that you have to offer